Lauren's mother was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease when she was 55 years old. How long ago was that?
That was almost 5 years ago.
Did she survive?
Yes, she's 59 now. She was a teacher her whole life and had to retire at 57. And now my dad, who retired also to take care of her, and now they, you know, just deal with it every day.
Is she home?
Yes, she's home. Yeah, you know, they live at home together, and he, you know, does everything. He cooks and cleans. He does her hair every morning. And
how did you discover it at 55? You'd have never thought of it, right?
Well, no, actually, both of her parents, my grandparents, both had it. Yeah, her dad, my grandfather, was diagnosed. I'm not quite sure because I was young, but I remember my aunt and uncle have said they saw signs when he was in his 50s as well. And he passed away in his early 70s. And then my grandmother passed away less than 10 years ago, I guess, from the disease. So when my mom started to show these symptoms, it was pretty clear. You know, she'd forget a story that I told her, forget that she spoke with someone. So it was pretty clear to us what was going on.
Did you know her mom through all of this, Seth?
When I met Lauren, which was around 6 years ago, was really the beginning, I think, of when people started noticing a difference. But even I could see a drastic difference in the first few times I met her. Honestly, her ability to verbalize things was the thing that I noticed was the most affected. Her ability to literally access words was really affected by it.
Are you angry about it?
Very. It's pretty unfair. But, you know, I think the things that make me angry are that, unfortunately, this disease gets very little attention, especially with people, you know, that are our age. They know very little about it. And I think that, you know, if we all come together, then we can find a cure and there will be no need to be so angry about it.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, you're in your 20s. How many kids in their 20s have to deal with it?
Yeah.
Not many.
I mean, I think when you're young, your grandparents are old, and you just kind of associate all this stuff to, like, old people problems, and you don't really have any personal connection to it. But as you get older and you see it happening to your parents and ultimately realize it could happen to yourself and your friends, it becomes much more real and not some imaginary old person problem, you know?
You worried about getting it?
Of course I am.
Have you taken any tests for it?
No, I think I'm not going to do that because I don't, unless there's a cure, unless there's a treatment for me to get, I don't need to know that now.
A Larry King special, The Alzheimer's Epidemic, CNN Sunday, May 1st, 8 Eastern.